Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, I'm looking at a problem that someone contacted me about. They want to use the Lightroom Print module to create an image file to upload to an online print service, but they're struggling. In this video, I'll explain how to do this, as well as explaining some of the many print module options. Before starting though, be sure to adjust and softproof the images you want to print. If you don't know how to do this, there are a few videos on my channel and website explaining how. I'll include the links in the video information below. I'll start by setting the paper size that I want to use. Although we're printing to a file, we should still do this as it controls the dimensions of the file. For this example, I'll select the 8x10 paper. You can see my selected image appears on a page in the preview window. If you look at the ruler to the side of the interface, you'll see that the page measures 8x10 inches. You can also see that the image size on the page is 8 times 5.333 inches. This is because there's a border around the image, and we'll look at how to adjust that shortly. If we look at the controls over on the right side of the interface, you can see that my layout style is set for a single image or contact sheet. We'll use this option for our example rather than the other layout styles. Looking at the preview, you can see that there are faint border lines displayed in grey. If you can't see these in your copy of Lightroom, it's probably because they're turned off. You can control which of the guides are visible using the Guides panel. The guides are there to help you position the image, and they don't appear in the final print. To change a guide, you can click and drag it into position. Alternatively, you can use the sliders in the Layout panel. Notice though that I can't set the sliders to have a zero margin. This means that there'll always be a border around the edge of my image. When I print the image to a file, then the file will also have this white border around it. The reason for the border is that I have the print job set to output to a printer that isn't set for borderless printing. What I need to do is switch to output to a JPEG file, because that's what I'll be sending to the online print service. Now I can click the custom file dimension option, and the grey border around the edge disappears. I can then maximize the space to display my image. Unfortunately, my image has a different aspect ratio to the paper I've chosen, so it will always print with a white border along the top and bottom. I could fix this in the image settings using the option Zoom the image to fill the page, but that results in part of the image being cropped on either edge. A better alternative is to set the right file dimensions in the Print Job panel. Now when I print to file, the image doesn't have a border. If we check the image information, we can see that it has a dimension of 3000 by 2000 pixels with a resolution of 300 dpi. You can control these dimensions using the Print Job panel in Lightroom. By setting the file resolution, you control not only the resolution, but the number of pixels. The number of pixels is determined by multiplying the resolution by the dimension of the image you've set. Now let's look at some of the other print settings you can use when printing your file. In the Print Job section, as well as file resolution, we can also opt to apply sharpening. The sharpening compensates for the softening effect that will occur during printing. Select the type of media that you'll be printing to, which is matte or glossy, and then the level of sharpening to apply, which is low, standard or high. You should check the type of media you'll be printing to with the online printing service, and then set this accordingly. You can also set the JPEG quality here. The higher the quality, the larger the file size that will be produced. The other option to check if you're going to send this file to a printing service is to set the profile. Many online printers like you to send them a file that's in the sRGB color space, and they don't really want the Adobe RGB color space. You may also want to set the rendering intent to either perceptual or relative. If you don't understand what these are, you can see my soft proofing tutorials. Otherwise, set it to perceptual, and that will probably give a good result in most cases. Currently, I have one image selected for the file. If we go to the Layers panel, I can change the number of rows and columns. This gives me the space to add other images onto this file. I could repeat the current photo so that it appears four times in the file. Alternatively, I could select multiple files to include. Now when I print the image, the file produced contains the four selected images. You may be able to notice a small faint gap between the images. This is because I've used the stroke option in Lightroom. This adds a thin border around each of the images, and you can control the color and the width of that line. Having made the changes, it's time to print the files ready to send to the online printing service. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have, please don't forget to share it with others and don't forget to subscribe. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you soon for another video.